Ravens flock, man. Ravens Nation, man. Flock Nation, what's good with y'all? You feel me? This ain't for no Eagles and shit. I just got this on because y'all don't even know where the fuck I'm working at. But, man, let's get into it. Before I get any further, shouts out to the homies. Shouts out to the gang. Shouts out to the Flock Nation. Everybody that be tuning in. Everybody that subbed. Even the people that just be watching. Shouts out to y'all. All my main homies, they always tap in. Y'all know who y'all is. Shouts out to y'all, man. But let's just get into this, man. Ravens signed Derrick Henry. Hold on, let's backtrack. Justin Madubuike. I kind of told y'all in one of my actual regular videos, I was foreshadowing. I already felt like, I literally said this, I already felt like Madubuike was back with us. Whether it was on a tag or not, I already felt it, man. That's the homie, man. That's the homie, yo. I ain't gonna put his biz out there and shit, but that's the homie. You know, I just seen the writings on the wall. It ain't nothing major. He was showing it off, so it ain't nothing major, but I seen Madubuike have a Audemars Piguet watch on, and that shit ain't cheap, you know what I'm saying? And Madubuike seemed like a humble dude, so once I seen that, I was like, oh yeah, he got that bag. And then the news didn't even come out until a couple of days later, so yeah, that went the way it did. I'm happy for Madubuike. It was a great signing, great offseason signing, great signing for the franchise in general, because we needed him. A lot of people that feel some type of way, they need to recognize that Terrell Suggs had, was it 14 or 13? Whatever Madubuike had for the season, Terrell Suggs in his best season had one more sack than that. So I just find it funny how anybody that has something to say about Madubuike or question his production, I find it funny how if you're not going to question Terrell Suggs and how, what, of course nobody's going to question it because how it turned out. But if you weren't there to see the evolution of Terrell Suggs, then it's not, you don't have much room to speak on Madubuike because it's low-key the same damn thing. That's how I knew he was going to stay. Once you start getting to, and this goes back to the Judon situation and the Za'Darius Smith situation, it was plenty of channels that be out there. I'm not going to call them out, you know, because then it's like I'm hating. But I've been saying this, and now it's funny how the whole Cat Williams and Shannon Sharp thing and everybody be saying like, oh, you can't even talk bad because it's like you hating. I've been saying this for a minute now, but I'm just used to it. But either way, a lot of people were sitting there saying, Ravens can't keep pass rushers. We can't ever hold on to good. We let the great ones go. No, we didn't. We have a measuring stick, okay? And if you're not in that level of Terrell Suggs or I can't even think of nobody better than Terrell Suggs for us other than Madubuike right now. But if you're not in that company, why should we pay you? You know what I'm saying? And that's why I never really cared to go back and forth about the whole Judon and Za'Darius Smith thing. But I spoke on it before last year. Not this past last year, but before then. Excuse me. But because people was pissed off that we didn't get Za'Darius, or Za'Darius backed out the deal last minute, whatever that bullshit was. But moving forward, Madubuike, since he got with the team, yo, has been elevating himself year in and year out. A lot of people don't give credit to who he's been able to be around as far as development-wise. Calais Campbell, what's the homie name that came from the Chiefs? I cannot remember his name right now. Damn, I cannot remember his name. But yeah, him as well. You know, just coming across people that's going to help his game in the long run, and it paid off for him. So I'm glad and happy. Justin Houston, that's who it was. Justin Houston. So I'm glad he was able to do what he set out to do, which was get another contract with the Ravens. I could tell, bro, wanted to stay with us. So that's all good stuff. Moving forward, I seen about the Geno Stone shit. I seen about the Patrick Queen shit. Ronald Darby shit. Like, all that stuff wasn't even phasing me. But it's going to bring me to my next point Once I noticed that the running backs were starting to get signed and shit, I've been trying to, you know, forewarn y'all, you know, we either gonna blow it up or stay with what we got and build off of that. We just blew it up. So, and I mean that by having Gus go to the Chargers, which is great for him. You know what I'm saying? I'm glad Gus finally should get the opportunities that he should have gotten with the Ravens, but didn't because of John. But who else? I feel like there's another running back that left. J.K. didn't leave. No, it was just Geno Stone and Gus. Okay. But either way, once I seen that was happening, and once I seen that Zach Moss was gone, once I seen that DeAndre Swift was gone, once I seen that the dude from the Raiders, I'm not a big fan of his, but once I seen he was going too, I said, man, we got to go for Derrick Henry now. It's no ifs, ands, or buts. So we're going to have all hands on deck for the draft because we can't miss. So at EDC, in EDC fashion, and I talked to this with my homie Fresh Life too, before all this shit started occurring. You know, EDC, he does really well when it comes to retaining players that we had and have shown us that they are Raven material or should be here long term. Now, Marlon, we could talk about that. That's another discussion for another day. But overall, aside from Earl Thomas too, overall, aside from Odell too, low key, but again, overall, EDC has been able to utilize his position and know when to hold him and know when to fold him in regards to retaining players. He has no issue from me in that department. Granted, again, the Earl Thomas thing, it was great when it happened. We thought it was going to be great. I can't fault him too much for that. Earl Thomas was a fucking nutcase. But he also helped us out too, because that's how I knew Chuck Clark was fucking trash. But moving forward, you know, aside from that, and there's points of times where if you really look at the situation, you can't fault EDC for every single move. But when it comes to this drafting situation, I feel like EDC, if you ever watch my videos, bro, you know, I'm very unbiased. I don't pick and choose who to fuck with, who I want to talk about. No, it comes off like that. But no, I genuinely go through my thought process and see what can we improve on, what's the weak points, what I don't like, what I do like. So I want to say this, EDC. You're doing a great job just as far as keeping the team competitive. But I'm going to need for us to really, really take a big leap forward in regards to this wide receiver situation. I don't know what you got up your sleeve, bro, but we got to do something about it. I wasn't too concerned with the running back situation. I had a feeling that y'all was going to make the right decision. I didn't think Gus would be out the picture. I don't know what's going on with JK as we speak, but still, I didn't worry too much about the running back situation. I had full confidence that we was going to make the right moves in regards to that. And I want to talk about Derrick Henry too. But again, we need to hit the jackpot when it comes to this draft coming up, man. That's all I'm saying, EDC. That's all I'm saying. Now, in regards to what is his name? Derrick Henry. In regards to Derrick Henry, this this is very interesting. We have not had a pure running back with the resume that of Derrick Henry. Now, we've had an all-around better running back than Derrick Henry. Now, if you want to argue with me about it, I'm going to come with facts. So if you got something to say in the comments, you better come correct. But we've had a better all-around back than Derrick Henry and Ray Rice, which was obviously cut short. Aside from that, the closest comparison I can ever give to Derrick Henry in his career that we got right now, and trust me, this is coming from me, y'all. I ain't Horace Torres. Like, if y'all go do y'all research on my videos, I was the first one to say smoking on any pack in regards to football players. I was the first one, okay? I start a lot of shit on this YouTube shit with this sports NFL shit, but I don't get my credit, so I ain't tripping on it. But it's times that I was the first to do it, and then the baby stole it from me and ran with it. Now everybody be saying it, whatever. I'm just saying, I was one of the biggest critics of Derrick Henry. Not to say I called Derrick Henry trash. I don't think I called him trash. But when we had that rivalry with the Titans, I really, for lack of better words, Derrick Henry was the op, you know? So I'm saying this in all sincerity and genuineness. I had to go do my research. I had to go sit there and really understand what we were getting in Derrick Henry, what we are getting in Derrick Henry. And before I get to my point about this, I want to also note that a lot of people don't like the Ravens signing older players, right? But as we see, a lot of people pick and choose off what's okay for age. Derrick Henry is approaching 30. I don't got no problem with it like that. But Derrick Henry is approaching 30. I don't see the outcrop of people saying, oh, he's washed up, he's old, he's this, he's that. You know what I'm saying? I had the same optimism for Odell Beckham. You know what I'm saying? I didn't go the way I expected it to. But either way, I just don't understand why people choose to stay on the fence about shit like this. Like, the comparison I'm about to give for Derrick Henry is going to highlight and prove why you just can't dismiss somebody just because they're older. Derrick Henry's comparison, from me, from my horse tours, y'all, the closest comparison I can give to Derrick Henry, Jerome Bettis. I'm not even bullshitting. Jerome Bettis. Jerome Bettis was not a straight-up receiving running back. He wasn't an all-around running back, but straight-up, I'm running through the middle, and there's nothing you can do to stop me. So much so, at 34, if I'm not mistaken, 33 or 34, Jerome Bettis was still playing football. It wasn't until he hit his early 30s where he had the most touchdowns in his career, which is crazy to me. I didn't even know that. I'm not a Pittsburgh Steelers fan, so I wouldn't know that. But this is what I'm saying about you just can't discredit somebody just because they're older, yo. Y'all can't keep saying that, man. Like, it's certain things you can't teach that a certain a rookie wouldn't be able to grasp until he got experience in order to know certain shit. So like you can't just keep dismissing age as a liability and saying, oh, they keep signing old players, they keep signing old players. Well, it was convenient for the situation because this is another point. So I saw the Ravens over everything. And I'm saying this because if I'm not mistaken, I know me and him had a conversation about this running back situation. And I don't know if it was him per se that I said this to, but I know I said this on one of these social media sites and shit, whether YouTube, Instagram, I don't know. I'm just saying I put it out there. I'm not paying more than $9 million to Derrick Henry. We ended up getting him for $8 million. $9 million, get fully guaranteed. I have no problems with that contract. I have zero problems with that contract. Would I have been comfortable if we paid Gus that much? Not really. would I have been comfortable if he paid any running back that type of money? Not really. But seeing as though who it is, Derrick Henry and all that, I'm fine with it. Now, the only concerns that I have in regards to this move is, what is our offense going to look like? And I don't mean that in a bad way, because I have much optimism in regards to what Todd Monken is able to do just as a offensive coordinator, what he was able to do last year. Now, granted, it wasn't his fault that we decided not to run the fucking ball because of John and the playoffs. But either way, I'm not going to bring Derrick Henry into this and say, oh, because Derrick Henry on the team, we have to feed him. No, use him for when we need him. But what I see as a That's So Raven moment, so to speak, like as I'm looking into the future, I don't know when Keaton Mitchell is going to be able to fully be back 100%. Aside from him, all we have is still Justice Hill, low-key. So we need somebody that's going to be able to take on a lot of the load, a lot of the carries, and not have any setbacks as far as injuries will go. And maybe Derrick Henry is what's the word I want to say? Maybe Derrick Henry is, I cannot think of the word right now. Y'all know what the fuck I'm trying to say. Maybe he won't get hurt. That's a plus. But either way, we need a workhorse. And who else better than motherfucking Derrick Henry that can help take care of the load? And that way we don't have to worry about the running back position so much going into the draft. I just seen a report. Shouts out to Falcon Ravens. He posted it. We reworked Ronnie Stanley contract. I would have preferred him being traded. I feel like we don't need him at this point. But the opposite side of this, if I take my feelings out of it, it's a smart move because, again, we don't have to worry about who we need as far as left tackle right away. At least you got another year to buy yourself time. So it's smart, very calculated moves on EDC behalf. I wouldn't say I'm impressed right now. I kind of expected certain things to happen. Madubuike, especially Derrick Henry, after I seen all the running backs be gone, it was going to happen. But yeah, shouts out to them. Patrick Queen. You know, I was one of the biggest fans of Queen, and I don't mean one of the biggest, like, oh, we needed him, he coming out of college. I'm not going to go that far, but I was one of the people that was, you know, rooting for his success early on before Roquan came. And to see how it went, to see how he treated the situations during certain times last year, to see what team he went to, come on, bro. Like, granted, now they was the ones that was offering the best deal for you, you know, kudos to you. But I just don't see the benefit in that one. I mean, we're going to be lining up against you twice a year. I don't know why you would want to put yourself through that. But, you know, whatever. Same thing with Gino. I don't know why you want to put yourself through that. But, you know, y'all going to get this work. Is that pretty much all we needed to rap about for right now? Yeah, that might have been it, y'all. Yeah, Derrick Henry comparison. It's like the Ravens got, we got our own Jerome Bettis. Might be up in low age, 29. That's all right. But I can't stress it enough. Jerome Bettis had one of his best seasons in his early 30s. Trying to think, who else? We need to talk about John Simpson. Shouts out to him. He got paid. Not sure what we're doing with Brandon Stevens. If we keep him, so be it. If we don't, so be it. Only concerns I have right now is how we're going to go about the offense in regards to Derrick Henry, what are we going to be running? Yeah, aside from that, I just feel like we got to secure the wide receiver room. Definitely get a few corners. Maybe one or two. Definitely get some linemen still. But I think our first pick should, if we ain't going to trade up, I still think our first pick should be wide receiver. Something like that, yo. Like, I don't know EDC. I don't got all the answers. I kind of fell back from watching college football this year. So I don't know what person may fit our team or so. But one of my underrated wide receivers that I like this year, Ricky Parasol out of Florida Gators. Yes, I'm biased because I'm a Florida Gator fan, but solid hands, man. So shouts out to him too. But I'm really intrigued to see what you do, EDC, when this draft come. Keep doing your thing, man. I'm gonna chill off the hardball situation for now, and let you do your thing, man. Ravens Flock Nation, Ravens Nation, man. I'm gonna holler at you on the next one, man. Gotta handle some shit today. Hopefully everything go right. Yeah, man, but I couldn't wait to get this video out of here, man. So hopefully y'all enjoyed it. Hopefully y'all understand where I was coming from with this Derrick Henry, and Ravens got their own Jerome Bettis now. I think it's gonna be a very fruitful off season for us, the way it's trending right now, but we gonna see. EDC, keep it up, man. Ravens Flock, Ravens Nation, man. I'm out, y'all.